Hi, dance fam. In this video, I'm going to take you through some tips on how to get started on your dance fitness journey. I get asked these questions a lot and how to get started if you're new, and this is for you. If you don't know who I am, my name is Joseph Corella, and I am the creator of 567 Broadway, a new musical workout. There's a link below for more information about that. As a performer and as a fitness instructor, I've learned a lot along the way, and I'm really excited to share what I have learned, and hopefully it will help you on your dance fitness journey. All right, without further ado, I think we should do this. You ready? Okay, tip number one, find what makes you happy. A lot of the time I see people working out, and not everyone, but I see a lot of the time they're like, oh, I hated that. But they go consistently. And I'm all about like doing things because you have to take care of your body, but we also have to take care of our mind. So I recommend trying different things and seeing what works for you. If you like it, continue to do that. If you don't like it and it's miserable and you feel miserable, don't do it. But again, I'm saying that because I have come across in different scenarios, people that will do something because they feel they have to. Physically, it might be really helping them, but mentally it's not. So I really want to recommend to you to try different things, see what makes you happy, and do that. And also give yourself a couple times to do something. So try it out at least a couple times, and that will for sure tell you that you're like, oh, okay, I like that or I don't. And I know for me, there's been classes that I have taken, and you know what? I didn't like it, and that's okay. And I don't go back to that. I connect to things that I truly enjoy. Also too, I understand some things take some work, and that's okay. But I for sure know when I am miserable taking something, and that is not good for my mind. And we're in this to take care of our body and mind. So I highly recommend trying 567 Broadway. But with what I just said, some people might not connect to that, and that is absolutely okay. And everybody tries different things and do what is best for you. And I think that's it for tip number one. Tip number two. I'm going to tip around. Tip number two, make a realistic schedule. Okay. I see this all the time. I do this myself. So I'm in it as well. Sometimes people make a schedule that like 20 classes in 1 week or 20 workouts, and I'm going to do this. You guys, this is about longevity. So make a realistic schedule. Start off light. For 567 Broadway, I did create a 28-day show calendar, which is down below. And that is a realistic calendar. I try to really make sure that I created it in a way to help really soak in it, all the information, but not over push ourselves too. So we want to make sure that we remember that this is about longevity. But you don't want to set yourself up to be disappointed because you're like, I was supposed to do all these classes and now I missed. I didn't do it and now I'm a horrible person. Come on now. I for sure know how that feels, and that's why I'm saying that. And I have to remind myself, you know what? If I did a little bit today, that's great. And if I didn't, it's okay, but I have a new day. Each day is a new day to keep going. But try and start off with a weekly realistic schedule, whatever that is for you, because I don't know your schedule exactly, but figure that out and make it realistic so that you don't set up yourself to be disappointed. Tip number three, we already touched base on this, but don't beat yourself up if you miss on your weekly schedule that you created. If you miss something, it's okay. And again, I am guilty of this. It's not easy. I know for me, I put a lot of expectations sometimes, and lately I have been much better about saying, you know what, I can only do this much for right now, and that's okay. As long as we're moving, that's all that matters, and that's something that I say, and I actually have to tell myself that. So I want to remind you that if you don't stick exactly to your schedule, you're okay. Each day, like I said, each day is a new day to make new choices, and as long as we're taking care of our body and our mind, because we got to take care of our mind, we're doing good. So make sure you remember body and mind, and if you're beating yourself up, it's not necessarily going to help you in the long run. So that's tip number three. That leads me to number four. Number four is, remember, this takes time. This can be a really hard one because being patient as you're learning a new craft can be really, really hard. And it does take some discipline. And that's the thing I love about dance. Trust me, you guys, my attention span is like pew, pew, all over the place. That's the thing that actually why I really connected to dance, is because it allowed me to get that energy out and it allowed me to focus in, which was really, really great, and connect to music and all these things that kept me motivated. Music is essential for me, central. And that's why I love dancing, is because I get to connect to the music and it helps motivate me to keep me moving. I know I've taken like certain fitness classes and the music is like, I am not connecting to the music at all. And it's like nails on a chalkboard to me, and it totally disconnects me. So for me, music is essential. But I, just going back to remember, it takes time. Be patient with yourself. I still have to remind myself this all the time, but be patient with yourself as you are moving forward. As long as we're moving forward, if it's a tiny step, great. If it's a big leap forward, great. But as long as we move forward, you know, and if you need to take a pause, you take a pause. But the more you do it, the more you get it. But it's not going to happen overnight. And I support you, and I am here for you to help you on that. And like my, you've seen with my dance tutorials, I really try to give you tips throughout that as well on how to keep going. And, you know, there's realistic things that happen that you're like, ah, I just want to give up. No, we got to keep moving, pause, break. But as long as we keep moving, that's all that matters. Last one, number five, have fun. So I gave you a lot of serious talk, somewhat serious talk on some tips, but realistic serious talk, shall we say. And number five, have fun. This is what it's all about. Again, reminder, this is about body and mind. So if you're not having fun, then no, that's not fun. There you go. But yeah, have fun. And that's why I'm telling you, it goes back to number one, which is find something that you connect with, whether it be 5, 6, 7 Broadway or something else. Find what connects to your soul and keep following that. And that's important. So don't make yourself do a workout that you're so miserable in. And you're like, yay, I got my heart rate up. But you were like crying throughout the whole thing. I highly recommend finding something that makes you happy and that you can have fun with. And then you can let go. And the more you do it, the more you get it. And if you're new, this is going to be great on helping you to become the best dancer you can be. And I support you 100%. If you ever have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out. Comment below any of your questions. I'm happy to answer. I try to be very active here on YouTube. And I'm here to really help you. And I'm so grateful that you have found my channel, or that you have been subscribed to it for a moment. And most importantly, just keep sharing the 5, 6, 7 Broadway love with your friends and your family. And we got to keep everybody moving and having fun. Number five, having fun. So thank you guys so much. If you please share this with someone that you feel like it would be helpful for them. And also make sure to subscribe, because I have a lot of other fun things coming up. And I can't wait to see you on stage soon. All right. Yeah.